Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I am coming to you from my little rocking chair in my bedroom. The time is 8:04 p.m. and tomorrow morning I am embarking on a challenge that I saw here on YouTube, and it is the 5 a.m. challenge. I'm not a morning person. I have never claimed to be a morning person. I have said before that I really struggle with mornings, but I thought I could do this for 5 days in a row, right? I could totally do this. Plus, I have a friend of mine who is not on YouTube, but we decided to go on this challenge together. So this means that for the next 5 days, I'm gonna be waking up at 5 a.m. and I will show you what I'm doing, because I will have my phone and I'll show you what time it is that I'm doing things, and I will kind of take the camera around with me during my morning time. And at the end of the 5 days, I'll do kind of a little check-in. So for me, the hardest part about this is going to bed at a decent time. It's 8 o'clock now. I hope to be in bed before 10. That's my goal, or in bed by 10. And tonight I have to go downstairs, and it's Sunday right now. This is Sunday, July the 7th. And I have to go downstairs and wash and cut up all our produce for the week. And then I need to work in my planner and plan my week. Also plan what I'm going to do in the mornings. So I hope you enjoy this. So I will see you in the morning.
Okay. I did it. Let's get this day started.
While I wait for my coffee to brew, let's talk. So this morning, let's back up. Last night I was asleep by 10, because I know I looked at the clock before I went to sleep and it wasn't 10 yet. So that's my guess. But I sort of cheated and took 2 Tylenol PM. But that was not to fall asleep. That was because I had a bad headache. A really bad headache. And I'm thinking, oh, this is not the night to start this. I'm going to wake up with a headache. Well, it's still there just a tad, but not completely. So let's see what the clock behind me says. 5:09. I woke up just like, I don't know if you do this when you know you have to get up super early, you like anticipate it and you wake up before that anyway. I did that, and I actually dreamed that I woke up early and got started. I'm not even kidding, guys. That's how much I'm thinking about it. But what I did was put my camera across the room, and so I had to take off the covers, get up and grab my camera from across the room to start. And when I first clicked on that was in my closet. And so I've got my robe on. I took my hair out of my buff. And now I wait for my coffee to brew. I'm gonna go outside and do my scripture writing like I usually do. However, there is zero sun, like no sun at all right now. And I mean, the sun comes up on the other side of our house, but our front porch is not a great place to sit. So I'm just gonna have to turn on the light and do it there. So let's see how this goes. But the important thing, okay, I've been talking for 2 minutes. The important thing is that I did it. I got up. And once I'm up, I'm up. It is 5:49. I just finished my scripture writing a few minutes ago, and I'm getting a little bit of, not sun, it's just light. But I did my scripture writing. I did the second half of Psalm 25, and then I did Psalm 26. And I've been writing the Psalms one at a time.
since January, I'm sorry, January, June the 1st, and it's going really well.
Today's a little bit different. I only have one child at home today because Brayden is at my in-laws. They took him 2 nights ago, so I'm sure he's having fun getting all the attention. And so Caleb is with me, and so I'm going to get up. I made a list. Of course, my planner is up in the bedroom next to my bed. But I made a list of what I was going to do with my early time. The thing is, Caleb is kind of my easy kid. Like, he will get up and make breakfast for himself. He's almost 8. And so he can do a lot of that kind of stuff. So I think this was a good first morning to kind of adjust to this. I mean, who am I kidding? It's going to take me all week to adjust. And then I'm going to, I don't know. This could start something amazing, and I could just be a morning person from now on. Who knows? But I've got my coffee, and I need to go upstairs and get dressed, put some makeup on, empty the dishwasher, start a load of laundry. And what time did I say it is? It's 5:51 now. So yeah, let's keep moving.
6:23.
I got all dressed. I have refit tonight, so that's a weird outfit of the day shot. But I've refit tonight, so I always dress for refit during the morning because I don't want more laundry. You feel me on that? And I put on some makeup and still drinking my coffee. And I'm gonna get to some chores. I'm just gonna do the dishwasher, put some dishes in there, and get started on some laundry. And Caleb is not up yet. But honestly, I don't expect him up for at least another hour. By the way, I'm not going to vlog every single thing I'm doing every day. I'm doing this mostly on the first day, but throughout the week, I will be kind of checking in periodically to let you know how it's going. So let's get moving.
Okay, 7:29. I have done everything on my little 5 a.m. challenge list except stretch. I haven't stretched yet. Maybe I will do that.
I'm being super productive, and to be honest, I'm getting a little tired, and Caleb is not even up yet. I would expect him up any minute now, so I'm kind of like, what do I do with myself? And the problem is, I know by the time bedtime comes along, when I get back from refit tonight, which probably won't be until close to 10, I'm gonna have a kitchen full of dishes. So, I don't know. I'm really hoping I don't peter out too soon.
Tuesday, July 9th, 5:20. I'm on my porch about to start my Bible reading and scripture writing, and let's recap yesterday.
Sorry for the terrible light. This is going to have to do. All right, yesterday, I'm going to make this quick. Day one was really good. I got so much done. I don't even remember the last time I checked in. Everything went really well. I had decent energy all day. I was also a little bit going on adrenaline because I had thing after thing after thing yesterday. I got up really early and then got all my stuff done. So that was like the big thing. And then Caleb had Taekwondo. As soon as we got home from Taekwondo, I had to go to work. As soon as I worked for a little bit, I had to go to the doctor's office. Then I came home and went back to work. Then I had to get dinner ready and go to refit. And I didn't get home from that until about 9:45. And if you don't know what our classes are, refit is a class that I teach, and it is 55 minutes of cardio and toning, and mostly mid to high intensity cardio. and I did great. I did great. My energy was awesome. And then Rev and Flow is the next class that I take, and I don't teach that one. I take it, and it's more of a toning, strengthening, balance type class that my friend Emily teaches, and it's really good. I love it so much. But about halfway through that, around 9 o'clock, I started really losing steam. Like, I cannot do this. I took a quick shower and then I went to bed. I cleaned up in the kitchen a little bit, took a shower and went to bed. And yeah, I probably laid in that bed for about an hour before I went to sleep. So I know I went to sleep before midnight, but it was rough.
I'm a little tired, or maybe a lot tired, but I'll go wash my hair. It's 8:18 and I'm struggling.
So I've gotten a lot done so far today. I'm gonna go back out on the porch because it's so nice. But I've showered, my hair is very crunchy. So I've got to scrunch out the crunch later, but it's mostly dry. But I've had like this, just this like kind of heaviness in me all morning. It's not spiritual or anything. It's just, I'm just moving a lot slower. And I did work out for 2 hours last night and then went like showered and went straight to bed. That is probably part of it. Like, my arms are sore, my hips and my knees are sore. And I think that's just because of my workout. Today, my kids are still asleep. Mike had them up very late last night. They were having a movie night. I didn't care because, I mean, Mike put them to bed. And so, you know, whatever. But they're still asleep and apparently need to. And it's summer, so it doesn't matter. But I've done like 2 loads of laundry. I'm just moving slow. I'm realizing it's not about getting in a hurry because, again, I don't want to burn myself out early today. So I think what I'm going to do is go up to my office and work a bit. I may edit some videos, but I just need to chill for a bit.
11:58 a.m., day 2, and I'm still alive.
All right, day 3. Oh, man. Oh, you guys, I'm struggling today. This is hard.
It's 5:28. And I've been up since 5, but I came downstairs and like my stomach does not feel good. It's just because it's morning. And if you don't know this about me, when I wake up, I must eat. I must put something in my mouth. And so I have my water by my bedside. I was running out of battery. And so I've been chugging that. I had like a handful of cereal. It's like, but usually a few minutes later, I feel better. I went to the bathroom. I am feeling a little bit better. That's why it's like almost 5:30 and I'm just now getting my coffee. But oh, so unflattering. There is no flattering 5 a.m. light. But I'm here on the porch. I'm gonna do my Bible reading. I think a big part of this was that I didn't get home from a homeschool meeting until after 10 last night. And then I stayed up and talked to Mike, of course, which is totally worth it, obviously. So it was a homeschool meeting, but still, it was late. So I was still in bed before midnight, but I need like a solid 7 or 8 to function. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my Bible reading and drink my coffee. Because it looks so good. Isn't it pretty? I'm enjoying the change in sky every morning. I will have to say that.
Guys, it's almost 7. I'm still here. I've been here for almost an hour and a half. Oh, I am procrastinating. It's really pretty out right now. Oh, I just want to sit here and not do anything.
9:53 a.m.
This has probably been my least productive day so far. I haven't made my bed. I haven't done any chores. That being said, there's not really a lot to do today, which is kind of a shock because there's always a million things to do. But I got, since I couldn't work a full day yesterday, I did almost 2 hours of work this morning, like I probably said I was, here in the living room while I watched Leave It to Beaver with Caleb. And I finished most of my coffee and I'm about to start a green smoothie, so. Yeah, my nose, I think there's something in the air today. My allergies are running wild. But we're headed to Taekwondo.
Day four. Good morning. So it is, because I want to show you. I want you to know what this is, right? 5:27. I hate everyone and everything, but I've got my coffee. I'm gonna do my scripture writing. I'll check in again later. Well, guys, I hit the snooze. Woke up at 5:10. I'm so tired. As you can see, it's 5:33 a.m. I just sat down with my Bible and my coffee, which I have spilled on myself. About to do my scripture writing, but look at my view. Isn't it dark?
All right, let's recap this week. Today is day five of the 5 a.m. challenge. It is, where's my phone? Last time I looked at the clock, it was a few minutes after seven. And here is what I have decided. I have known, first of all, and I said this earlier, that I am not a morning person. I was not meant to be a morning person. I am a night person, and I really am okay with that. That being said, I learned this week that I can wake up at 5 a.m. I can have a good day. I can be productive. But do I need to wake up at 5 a.m. every day in order to be productive before my kids get up? And the answer is a no. I've decided after this week that, I mean, yes, I have been able to get a lot done, and I've had more time with my kids during the day, which has been wonderful. Well, I shouldn't say more time. I've had the same amount of time. I am just able to spend more focused, I think that's a better way of putting it, more focused time with them because I've gotten so many things out of the way before they wake up. I know this is so not a new concept, but it's kind of a new realization for me. That being said, what I'm gonna try to do is instead of waking up at 5, I'm gonna try for 6 or 6:30. Like I've said before, my kids don't get up till like 8, 8:30. And you know, I would fully expect, now that I've said that, for someone to come bounding down the stairs. But I think if I try for 6 or 6:30, I could still have my Bible reading time. I could still do a load of laundry. I could still take the dishes out of the dishwasher. I can still do that daily chore, whatever that thing is. Not vacuuming, obviously. But I could still do all of those things before they wake up. I can edit YouTube videos. I could do some work. Obviously, just email, no phone calls. I could do a lot of things if I get up just a little bit earlier. Another thing I mentioned and realized is that when I wake up at 5, like by 7:30, 8, definitely by 9 o'clock, I'm done. I'm not only really sleepy, but I also am really grumpy. Like, I tolerate no funny business. And the truth is, even in the school year when the kids are going to bed earlier, my family still needs me at 8, 9 p.m. And I mean, that's just too important. And also, I don't take naps. I think I've taken 2 naps this week, and honestly, I feel like garbage when I wake up from naps. I know naps are revitalizing for some people. I like rest time, but naps, I just don't like it. It's almost like I'm starting my day over again. I wake up like, and my stomach hurts, and it's just like, no. I'm just needed in the evenings, and also two nights a week, I work until 10:30 or 11 at night. I need to do that. I need to be working. I get a lot done then. So we will see where this goes, but if you enjoyed this series, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. And if you're brand new here because you saw the hashtag or the title, be sure and click that red subscribe button. I have a lot of videos coming your way soon. I know I always say that, but I mean it this time. I'm behind. And now if I get up a little bit earlier, I can maybe edit these and get them out to you, which would be so exciting. Let me know what you think in the comments section about the 5 a.m. challenge. Are you a morning person? Are you a night owl? What is it? What's the meme? I'm not an early bird. I'm not a night owl. I'm just some permanently exhausted pigeon. And yes, I think we're all that at some point. I hope you're having a great day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.